order this Supreme Consciousness. So my Manishina, Manishina means those who are thoughtful, philosopher, those who can take up things by philosophical conclusion, that I am Consciousness, I am the part and parcel of the Supreme Consciousness. Therefore my duty is to act according to the Supreme Consciousness. Just like your hand is a part of your body. Now, it is moving according to my consciousness. The hand is not moving in its own way. As I want, let the hands be moved, let my legs be moved, let my eye be opened and see. So I am dictating and these parts are working. Similarly, we are all parts and parcel of the Supreme Consciousness. When we train ourselves to move and act in according to that Supreme Consciousness, then we become transcendental to all these pious or impious activities. That is the technique. The karmajang buddhi yukta hi phalang takta manishina. Manishina means thoughtful. Those who are thoughtful, those who have understood that I am the part and parcel of the Supreme Consciousness and let me act in that way, then what will be the result? Just see, the fine result. Janma bandha vinir mukta padanga chanti anamayam. Then he becomes free from the bondage of birth and death. No more birth and death. Janma bandha. This is a very strong, subtle, you see, janma, janma mitya jara vyadhi. Modern scientists, modern philosophers, they do not think about these four things, janma mitya jara vyadhi, birth, death, disease and old age. They set them aside. Oh, let them be happen. Let us enjoy this life, hugs and dogs. This is not human life. Human life is meant to make a solution of this bondage. Life, I mean birth, death, disease and old age. If the human civilization has not made a solution of these four things, that is not human civilization. Human civilization is meant for making a complete solution of these things. So here, in the Bhagavad Gita, just see how the Lord says, the karmajang buddhijuktahi. Karmajang. Karmajang means whenever you act, there will be some reaction. If you act good things, there will be good reaction. If you act bad things, there will be bad reaction. But reaction, either good or bad, that is in higher sense, all suffering. I have already explained to you some other day, that suppose by good action I get good birth, good riches, and good features of the body, good education, all these things I get. But that does not mean that I am free from the material pangs. The material pangs are janma mitya jara vyadhi, birth, death, old age and diseases. Because you are rich man, because you are beautiful man, because you are educated man, because you are born in an aristocratic family, that does not mean that you have avoided death, old age and disease. So we shall not be concerned with pious activities or impious activities. We shall be concerned with transcendental activities that will save me from this bondage of birth, death, old age and disease. That should be our aim of life. We should not be hankering after good or bad things, because everything here, in higher consciousness, everything material. Take for example, suppose you are diseased, suffering from some disease, you are lying on the bed, and you are eating in that stage, you are passing your nature's call in that way, and taking bitter medicines, and always you have to keep by the nurses clean, otherwise there is some obnoxious smell. In such a condition you are lying, and some friends come to you and ask you, my dear such and such, how are you today feeling? Yes, I am today feeling well. What is this well? He is lying on the bed, he is passing his nature's course in that way, he is eating bitter medicine, and he cannot move, all these inconveniences, and he says that I am well. Similarly, in our material conception of life, if we think I am happy, that is foolishness. That is foolishness. There is no happiness in material life. It is impossible to get happiness. Then we do not know meaning of happiness. Therefore, this very word is used, manish, you know. We want to happy to become by some extraneous, artificial means. And how long it will stand? It will not stand. It will again come back. Suppose by intoxication you feel happy. Oh, that is not your actual happiness. Suppose by chloroform, I am unconscious, I don't feel the pains of operation. Oh, that does not mean that I am out of these pains and pleasures. This is artificial. So real pleasure, real life is here. As recommended in Bhagavad Gita by Sri Krishna. Just see. Karmajang buddhijuktahi phalang takta manishina. Manishina means the thoughtful. They give up the reaction of work. Being situated in the platform of consciousness, and the result will be the janmabandham vinirmukta. This bondage of birth and death and disease and old age, he becomes free from that. Then the next life, padam gacchanti anamayam. Anamayam. Anamayam means where there is no death, the old age, no birth, no disease. That is possible. That is called Vaikuntha. Vaikuntha. The Sanskrit word is Vaikuntha. Vaikuntha means vigata kuntha. Kuntha means anxiety. Anxiety. Here, due to our material contamination, we are always full of kuntha, anxiety. Even a bird, when he's eating, he's seeing like this, this way, this way, this way. Somebody is coming, or kill me. Full of anxiety. We are also anxious. The politician is anxious. So long we are in contamination of these material body, we must be anxious. We must be anxious. There is a nice instruction by Prahlad Maharaj, a great devotee, a boy devotee. And he was from his boyhood, childhood, from his mother's womb, he became a devotee by the grace of Narada Muni. That is history. Now, He was 5 years old boy, and his father was too much materialistic. And he wanted that his son should be great politician, economist, and so on and so on, just like the materialists want. But the boy is a devotee. So father did not like the idea. So one day he called his boy, my dear boy, come on. He came, a small boy, sit down on my lap. All right, my dear boy, will you kindly tell me what you have learned, the best thing in your school? Yes, my dear father, I shall tell you. So he says like this, Tat sadhu manne suravarja dihinam, sada samudra bhikina dhyam asad grihat hityanda hitya atma ghatam grihyanda kupam banangato jad harima asrayita. My dear father, he is addressing his father, oh, the best amongst the materialists. Now, he is not afraid. His father was very powerful. And there is a story which I'll narrate one day. Now, today is shortly I'm giving some in his thanks. So he says, my dear father, you are the greatest of the materialists. But to my opinion, that is the best thing. If people should give up this materialistic life and devote himself for searching out God, then he will be free from the anxieties which is due to him due to his material connection. That's how see the nice. The hitya tasadmanne suravajya dekhinam sada samudvigna dhiyam. Persons who are always full of anxieties. Why? That due to their material connection. Asat. Asat means matter. Matter will not stay. However, you may chemically try to preserve it, it will not stay. Therefore, it matters. Another name is Asat. And spirits, another name is Sat. Sat means which exists. Asat means which does not exist. Antamattimidiha. Nittasukta sarivina. We have already discussed that this body is antavat. It has got end. But the consciousness or the spirit soul, it is not, it is endless. So the endless, I mean to say ever-existent soul being contaminated by this body, is full of anxiety. So Prahlad Maharaj thinks that in order to realize his self for self-realization, if he gives up all material engagement and takes to the path of self-realization, that is the best way of his life. And the father became angry, what nonsense he is taking. A 5 years old boy is talking of self-realization. I wanted to make him a great politician, economist. Now he's talking of this nonsense and hityatma ghatam grihanda kupam. He's describing that this family life is just like a dark well. If a man is put dark well, be engaged. Be whatever you are, that doesn't matter. But act it on the platform of consciousness. And that platform, acting on the consciousness, is Lord Chaitanya has made very easy. Just like there are some note makers of school books, easy study. So Lord Chaitanya has recommended that you may be engaged in whatever occupation that may be, good or bad, we don't mind for that. But you must hear the Krishna Katha. You must continue to hear this Bhagavad Gita. That is, for this we are trying to organize this institution. That you come, whatever you do, that doesn't matter. Everything will be adjusted by and by. Because, as I have described in the beginning, the sinnatang sarata krishna riddantas avadran. Everything will be adjusted as our mind becomes clear, simply by hearing. So this process, this association of hearing about the Krishna katha, what Krishna is speaking and what is spoken about Krishna, if we continue about this process and chanting the Krishna name, you'll practically see how much your heart is becoming clearer and clearer and how much you are making progress towards spiritual realization and real identity of pure consciousness. Thank you very much. Any question?
If a good man who is passed through the stages of being ignorant and passionate, and he's really a good man, is walking down the street, let's say, in Delhi or Istanbul or any place, any city, and he sees a very young man beating up on a very old man, just for no reason at all, he's just beating him up, beating him to death, and the old man is sort of calling out for help, and there's a few people standing around. And as he approaches, he begins to get stirred by this scene. And being a good man, he feels the whip on another human being's back. Now, as a good man, should he not take sides on two people quarreling and accept it and just walk on, even though he feels something welling up there? Or should he give way to what would be a passionate desire and try to interrupt and stop this injustice, so to speak?
The whole idea is that action, either in ignorance or passion or goodness, we have discussed that point, that doesn't matter. That action should be done from the spiritual consciousness platform, that's all. Then you transcend the reaction. Just like, for example, Arjun's fighting. This fighting is on the modes of passion. Passion. Now, when that work of passion, if he does, now Arjun was thinking not to fight because he thought that fighting with my brothers, with my relatives, is not good.
Yeah.
So from material point of view, it is all right. From material point of view. But the thing is that in material point of view, if you do act good work, you have to enjoy the reaction. That is the point. As I have already explained, that by your good work, you get good birth, you get good wealth, you get good education, good features of body. But that is not the solution of your problem. Here, the whole thing is that how to act. If we act from the material platform, even in the modes of goodness, that is also not solution of my life. But even in the spiritual, from the spiritual platform, if we act which apparently may seem to be acts of passion, that is not reactionary. That is not reactionary. Just like Arjun. Now Lord says that you become free from the reaction of your activities. That is the proposition. Now, at the same time, he is inducing Arjun to fight. The fighting is on the platform, on the modes of passion. Does it mean that simultaneously Krishna is inducing him to be entangled in the reaction of passion modes? No. That action even apparently appears to be being acted on the platform of passion, it is transcendental, because it is direction of the Supreme Consciousness. So whole thing is that we have to, just like the same example can be cited, that a soldier, he is killing his enemy. And the soldier is rewarded. Oh, you have killed such a big enemy, you are rewarded. Do you mean to say by killing one is rewarded? But he is not acting on his own platform. He is acting on higher consciousness platform, higher order. So if a commander's order can give him immunity from the reaction of being hanged, why not God's command? That is the thing. So we have to discriminate whether I am in the modes of ignorance or passion or goodness. No. We have simply to see whether I am acting under the direction of the Supreme Consciousness. That is the thing to be said. Then we are free. Then our life becomes free. That thing we have to learn. Yes. Yes, materially you are responsible. Because materially you are responsible for all acts, good or bad, that I have already explained. So you may think that you have taken the responsibility of maintaining your brother, but at the same time you are responsible for all the reactions. For all the reactions out of that act. It may be bad or good, that doesn't matter. But our problem is not to be infected with the reaction. If you think that bringing up your brother, it is good thing, you are doing good thing, that's all right. And you will have the good result of it. But that having that good result does not mean that you are free from the reaction. Now our problem is that we want to be free from the reaction. So long, the same answer is there, that the reaction of my good work, that I get good birth, I get good education, I get sufficient wealth, or I get good features of body, these things are goodness of this material world. But that does not make solution of the disease in which there are badi, birth, death, old age and disease. The whole problem is that we have to get out of this material existence. So from the material point of view or platform, any act, good or bad, that will have material reaction. And we want to get out of this material reaction. That is our point of view.